And what is Jamel looking for in a college?
Opportunity to play, the coaching staff, getting along with the players and the people around there, and just like the whole atmosphere of the college and coming out with a good education also.
For the Varsity Sports Zone, I'm Bob Hartman.
Gain of 17.
Boy,
knocked
great
out of bounds by Jarvis Johnson.
Great throw and an even better catch by Harris. Just to hold on, he was drilled by Jarvis Johnson. Good throw. He fits the football in nicely, does Walter Washington. Watch the hit from the defensive secondary, right in the small of the back by Jarvis Johnson.
Wait, Jarvis hurt himself on the hit.
Yeah, Jamel Harris holds on to the three quarters.
Third and five at the Rutgers 44. Washington with time, got a man there. Oh, that's a big time catch. First down, Temple by Jamel Harris. And they're gonna mark him at the 27-yard line. First down, Owls.
Harris going back to the huddle and said, feed me, Walter, because he's made two of the best catches you'll see on a Saturday afternoon. This one, terrific. Walter Washington, not a whole lot of room to fit the football in, and that's just effort. I mean, he goes up and gets the football and takes it away from the defender. That's a terrific throw and a great catch by Jamel Harris.
To Biggie's football and how we went on and on and on about Larry Fitzgerald, the ball attacking skills. Get the hands and arms out, get the ball, bring
never
it
never got to his body.
That ball went off. The throw short to Jamel Harris. Points off of turnovers today. Rutgers has 10 points off of turnovers to 6 for Temple. And Rutgers has 6 sacks against the Temple offense.
Well, Harris did an excellent job of taking a pass that would have been trouble if he was tackled inbounds to get out of bounds. That was a good effort to get to the sideline.
1:48 to go. Washington got a man there, and that's Harris. Harris, they made an attempt at the football. He's able to hold on. Manny Collins, one of several defenders for Rutgers, who's really been outstanding today.
Boy, that was a good throw.
It was.
That was an excellent throw down the middle of the field, 22 yards. Good pitching, 90 yards. Last see if he runs it here.
He accounted for 350 yards last year. Here's the blitz, and a throw, and they got the first down across the 30 to the 32-yard line. And they fed that one in to number 10, Jamel Harris. So Jamel Harris getting it done. How about this? Ebay fighting forward. He's in the pit territory inside the 30 to the 29. A gain of 23 yards. First down, Temple. By Walt Harris, seeing his defense get chewed up by this Temple passing attack.
Well, Bucci's come to play today. Mr. eBay stepping up, catches it right in stride, and Walter Washington doing an excellent job of hitting him right in stride. Look at that tight spiral and great hand catch. He attacks the football and then gets it outside, takes the hit from Jake.
Drive started back at the Temple 20-yard line after a punt. Out pattern. Great tackle. Well done. Well done on the edge by Taze Morris, the free safety, a gain of four. He stopped the sixth spot right there.
You can't draw up two better defensive tackles than the first one you see by Clint Session and now by Tez Morris. Just puts his helmet right in the middle of Jamel Harris and drives him out of bounds.
Conference of 3-2 overall. Washington on an out pattern. They scored on this play in the first half. They won't score here. Fine play by Sam Bryant, one of the extra DBs in the game. And that pass to Jamel Harris. Washington with his yard and a touchdown, 9 for 9 in the second half. Kirkley, 21 rushes for 86 yards and 2 touchdowns.
4th and 2, Washington. There's a catch and it's good for the first down. They got it to Jamel Harris, the sophomore from Shrewsbury, New Jersey.
Yeah, you get that wide out on a linebacker, just in a little option route to the outside in a little bit of space. Good throw.
A completion down to the 10-yard line. Got to separate him from the ball. Jamel Harris makes the tackle. Ray Henderson with the tackle for Temple. Pocket 241, a gain of 18.
Good protection by the Temple offensive line that time, and allowing Harris to buy some time to get to the middle. Watch Walter step up back into the pocket. No hesitation, just gets it over Raja, the defensive tackle. And as you said, a couple defenders trying to separate the football from Jamel Harris.
But they do have the luxury of Billups back available to be in the backfield. Instead, they throw, and it's Jamel Harris who has had a hand injury but slashes the grass there, moving the ball nicely for first down yardage. The junior from New Jersey had a couple pickup of 18 amongst the skill positions. We'll see Ferguson coming off that 110-yard performance a week ago. Billups in the rotation there as well. No Mike Neal, the fullback, out with that elbow injury up front. John Gross makes it.
Temple football, new look, new leg, new attitude.
Otherwise, it's been a fake punt, two legitimate punts, and that bizarre turnover. It is caught. Harris getting off the ground. He's got 7. Ridden out of bounds by Antonio Smith.
There you go. That's a nice little timing route there. If you're going to do a 3-step or a 5-step drop, you get the pre-snap read. There's McCann. Boom, 1, 2, 3, hit, let it go, and throw to a spot. I don't care if you're Deion Sanders on the outside. If you have inside leverage and your receiver runs the right route, 4, rolled to 6, you can't get over there.
From the 33, play action. And that'll be good for another first down. Excellent balancing acts there by Harris. Had the presence of mind to sneak in front of Antonio Smith.
Well, see, they go to the play action, but the only reason why play action is going to be effective is you get your running game going. You're just trying to hold the linebacker. Ferguson, I believe, missed his block, but fortunately the tackle was able to get enough of the end run.
Ferguson on the carry. He's got Bundy in the backfield, his fullback. Gordon, their leading receiver, with Jamel Harris in the tight end. Azubu BK, he's a redshirt freshman, East Stroudsburg, Pennsylvania.
Real good hands, got huge hands for his body size, monstrous hands.
Leads the Owls with 21 catches, and they haven't even looked in his direction yet. Almost intercepted, read perfectly by, guess who, Devin Hester.
If he picks it off, he's going the other way quickly. Harris, he jumped the route, good route recognition by Hester. He jumped the route of Harris, and you know, all he did was read the quarterback's eyes. You have a young guy, DeSanzo, just focusing in and zeroing in on his primary
project
target.
On Clayton's reputation. Clayton Block, a blueprint for success. To the sideline and caught. It's Harris. And that's good for the first down to the 45.
Nice throw out there going to his left. And 10, Harris, we've seen him have some flashes, and looks like he got a little bit nicked up.
By Bowling Green's John Nicholson.
But a nice catch. He got his feet in bounds. If he got a sting or something.
He's had that hand injury coming in as well.
Yep.
It's the right hand.
Which is really tough when you got to catch footballs.
Anticipation, what's about to go down. You can feel the vibration from